Christian MP condemns completely absurd criminal investigations into LGBT beliefs. A Christian MP in Finland has called the criminal investigations into her views on homosexuality incomprehensible. The Finnish Prosecutor General on Thursday ordered two new criminal investigations into Päivi Räsänen over comments she made to journalists. The investigations relate to the Christian Democrat MP's discussion around the Bible, Jesus, sin and grace on a program hosted by Maria Veitola on MTV3 in February 2018 and a radio discussion with journalist Ruben Stiller called What Would Jesus Think About Gays, which aired in December 2019. During both programs, she reiterated her views on sexuality, which are contained in a 2004 pamphlet she wrote called Male and Female, He Created Them. Räsänen is already being investigated over the contents of the pamphlet, as well as a tweet she posted last June in which she directly quoted Romans 1:24-27. The authorities have already decided to prosecute over the tweet. In a statement in Finnish, Räsänen said she has now twice been interviewed by the police in Pasila, Helsinki, over her talk show appearances and that she's awaiting two further interrogations. She said that the police concluded no crime had been committed and that it was the prosecutor general who had ordered the pre-trial investigations. I find the situation incomprehensible and completely absurd, she said. These requests for investigation and the criminal investigations launched on the basis thereof seek to limit freedom of expression and religion and to create a climate of self-censorship for Christians. At the same time, there is a risk that the media and journalists will start to cut off some of the discussion. The cycle of fear and silence should not be accepted. The criminal investigation extended to the pastor who published Räsänen's pamphlet, Reverend Dr. Johan Pohjala. Dr. Pohjala, who is Dean of the Evangelical Lutheran Mission Diocese of Finland, is accused of ethnic agitation. He says Helsinki police interrogated him for 5 hours on Friday 11th over his involvement with a pamphlet. He denies inciting ethnic agitation. In my view, Mrs. Räsänen's text is not defamatory or insulting to homosexuals. In my answers, I showed that the booklet teaches in line with Christian anthropology that every person is precious and being created in the image of God, regardless of sexual orientation, he said. This does not mean, however, that people are not responsible before God for their way of life or moral choices. The homosexual lifestyle is contrary to God's order of creation and a transgression against His will. If one is not allowed to teach this publicly, the message of sin and grace will be left without a foundation and freedom of religion will decline. Very interesting, I may say. It turns out now Christians are becoming the minority and homosexuals are kind of becoming the majority. They are few, yes, but if they're starting to accuse people for quoting the Bible, for citing the Bible, then it's turning out to be persecution for Christianity. And this makes me believe and see that we are actually living in the end times, because the Bible says these things will happen in the end times. Christians will be persecuted for believing in Christ, and we see this happening seriously. So I know that we are in the end times and we ought to know that too. Thank you so much for watching this video. It's been a pleasure hanging with you all through. If you're new to this channel, remember to subscribe. But if you've been here for a while and you've subscribed already, thank you for subscribing. Well, I'll see you again in my next video tomorrow. Ciao.